Hi students, how are you all? Yes, today we are going to learn the new lesson biomolecules. So biomolecules means we can understand bio means which is related to living things. Molecules means which is related to chemistry. So the chemicals involved in the biological living things we are going to learn in the name of biomolecules. Okay, so the biological process, many biological process takes place because of chemical reaction. So if you take the biomolecules present in all the living things, if you see any kind of living thing which having certain biomolecules, what are the familiar biomolecular compounds? We know that carbohydrate, proteins, lipids, then we can say nucleic acid. So these are the certain biomolecular compounds. Okay, so what is the uses of these biomolecular compounds, which is giving as a, which is used as a fuel, which gives energy for the biological process, right? So many process takes place in our body. Okay, so all the living things want to do any work or which having some, which need some energy, may the biomolecular compounds only giving that energy. Okay, right. So for human being, if you say what are the elements are present in the human body, so elements present in human body: carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, phosphorus, and then hydrogen. Like many elements are present in the human body. If you see, all the compound may combine into various compound, it may form the new variety of compounds which is present in the living organism, right? So addition to that, what is biochemistry? What's the definition for biochemistry? So we know that we have to learn. That means the field to study about, okay, the field, particular field to study about the chemical, chemistry behind the biological process. Chemistry behind the biological process. The chemistry behind, that means that we have to learn certain field, that process, the chemical reaction takes place in biological process or biological functions, that field only we can say biochemistry, right? So the biochemistry, we are going to learn importance of these biomolecules and then its uses, and also its necessity we will learn. Some of the biomolecular compounds we are going to learn now. Okay, familiar biomolecular compound, we know that carbohydrate. So most abundant biomolecular compound or organic compound in the living things, that is nothing but carbohydrate. Okay, so carbohydrate means it's having some another name. It is also called saccharides. Sorry. What do you mean saccharides? Sweet or sugar. See, the Greek word saccharon is derived. It is modified into saccharide. So what do you mean saccharon? Sugar. So maximum of carbohydrate having sweet in taste. Okay. And also we can say they are hydration of carbon. Carbohydrates are called hydrated carbon. What do you mean hydrated carbon? Hydration means what? Hydrate means water. So addition of water only called a hydration. So hydration of carbon means, if you see the carbohydrate compound which may have carbon with certain ratio of water molecule, but you cannot see as a whole water molecule. It will present in carbohydrate as a hydrogen as well as OH group. So what is a general molecular formula for carbohydrate? CnH2O n times. So number of carbon depends upon number of carbon, number of hydrogen and OH group, hydroxy group present. Here if you see 1000 particular carbohydrate, 2 hydrogen we can see. So the ratio of water also similar with that carbohydrate compound. That means carbohydrate compound having the ratio of hydrogen 1000 is similar with water ratio. Water having 2:1 ratio of hydrogen to oxygen, the same ratio is present in carbohydrates also. Okay, then we can classify the carbohydrate based on its hydrolysis. Okay, so we can classify the carbohydrate based on hydrolysis. What do you mean hydrolysis? If you add the water, with water it will give certain product. Based on the product on hydrolysis, carbohydrate you can classify monosaccharide, oligosaccharide and then polysaccharide. So what do you mean mono? If you hydrolysis, you will get only one type of product. If you get two type of product or three type of product, up to 10 if you get, that is oligosaccharide. More than 10, if you hydrolyze one particular biomolecule or carbohydrate, it gives more than 10 product, means we can say polysaccharide. Okay, right. Some example for this carbohydrate we are going to see. For example, D-glucose. What is the structure of D-glucose? CH2OH, COH, H, COH, H, OH, CH2OH. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here one more carbon, CH2OH. So this is the structure of D-glucose. And also we can see for D-fructose. This is called D-glucose. Why, sir, it is named D? I will say. Okay. The structure of D-fructose, CH2OH, OH, OH, H, then ketone compound with the secondary alcohol. This is called D-fructose. Some example we are saying, why it is named DL, following heading we will see. Okay, now you may have get a confusion, from where we can prepare this carbohydrate compound, right? Well known process, that is photosynthesis process, we know very well. In the photosynthesis process, green leaves only preparing maximum amount of carbohydrate. Okay, so in the photosynthesis process, green leaves having chlorophyll with carbon dioxide and water in the presence of sunlight, they produce carbohydrate with oxygen. So in this process we will get some glucose like carbohydrate. So this is the manner we can prepare the carbohydrate. Okay, now the next heading, configuration of carbohydrate. What do you mean configuration? Arrangement. Configuration means arrangement. Based on the arrangement, we have different type of classification or naming system in the carbohydrate. Okay, so DL like we'll say, but before that we must know all the carbohydrate or maximum of carbohydrates are optically active. So you may ask, what is optically active? Okay, what do you mean optically active? It will rotate the plane polarized light in clockwise or anti-clockwise. Okay, so we must know what is plane polarized light. Okay, so normal light may diverge in all direction. If you pass through the Nagel prism, like some instrument, it will polarize only particular direction, that is called polarized plane light. Okay, plane polarized light. That light, if you pass through any compound, that light may rotate towards clockwise or anti-clockwise. Based on that, we'll say that is the compound is optically active or optically inactive. If you take maximum of carbohydrates are optically active. What's the condition for a compound should be the optically active? It should have at least one chiral carbon. What do you mean chiral carbon? See, the carbon having valency 4, you know, that carbon attached 4 valency are entirely different. That 4 group attached in the carbon entirely different means we can say that is chiral carbon. In our book, they may indicate with their asterisk symbol. Okay, so one carbon with 4 different group attachment arrangement is called a chiral carbon. So based on the chiral carbon, we can say that is optically active or optically inactive. So how many chiral carbon is there? Based on that, it will produce the isomer. Okay, different arrangement. Isomerism, we know that. Okay, so the number of chiral carbon gives number of isomer. Okay, so in the 11th itself, we may studied about Fischer projection formula. Okay, he has taken the glyceraldehyde compound. Based on that, he gave a new idea that is called a Fischer projection formula. Right, so for carbohydrate compound, we will give two type of naming, that is D, other one is L. Okay, the D also you can mention with a positive charge, L may mention with a negative charge. Okay, so how will you give the compound is D or plus or L or minus? Based on their rotating nature of plane polarized light. Certain compound, for example, we will take one glucose. That glucose compound rotates the plane polarized light towards the clockwise direction. We can say that is textrorotatory. That rotation name is called textrorotatory. So one compound rotating the plane polarized light towards clockwise means we can say textrorotatory. What are the compounds are having textrorotation property? We can say D. Suppose, sir, this glucose rotates the plane polarized light towards anti-clockwise, we can say that is levorotatory. Levorotatory. So levorotatory means we can give the symbol L, right? Or we can mention plus minus, right? So based on the compound rotating the light, we will give the name D or L. Okay, so the D or L also we can write D plus, it is also equal to L plus. Okay, that means if anywhere text rotation, if you write D plus, it is also you can mention D, sorry, L plus. Okay, otherwise if you find L minus, see L or minus we'll use to know that L minus also equal to D minus. So we may get confusion. D means textrorotatory, L means levorotatory, plus means textrorotatory, minus means levorotatory. If you know this, you can understand. Plus charge textrorotatory, L with plus na, that plus indicates a textrorotatory. The same way minus textrorotatory, but here because of minus we can say that is levorotatory, right? So the symbols may change the property, that is important. If you know these two, we can clear about all the remaining. Okay, then some examples we can see for DL configuration. All the compounds compared with glyceraldehyde, so we must know what is the structure of glyceraldehyde. CH2OH, we know the structure of glycerol. See here, the plus, the dot having one carbon, HOH. here aldehyde compound. This is called diethylsteraldehyde. See, diethylsteraldehyde is a base. Based on that, we are going to give the name for other compound. For example, D glucose, how will you write? The CH2 group attached to carbon having HO group. The same way, if any compound having some other group or the same group with some branch, any compound having means we can say D. For example, if we write the example, we can understand. H-O-H, then H-O-H, CH2-OH. This is called D-glucose, CHO, D-glucose. Why, sir, this is called D-glucose, right? Because, listen carefully. The CH2OH group attached carbon having left side hydrogen, right side OH group. The same way in the glucose, CH2OH group attached carbon, left side we have hydrogen, right side OH group. So, this is our arbitrarily designed formula or initially taken if there HOH form a D, HOH, so D. Suppose if you want to find L, you just interchange this HOH, H, then OH, here also CH2OH, CHO. This is called a L-glyceraldehyde, okay. So, any compound having the CH2OH group attached carbon, OH first and then hydrogen, they will initiated with a L. So, here, if you interchange this H and OH, we can say L glucose. Are you clear? So, as a base, we have to take if the compound having HOH formation in the glyceraldehyde, the similar formation having any other compound, they will be named with D in the prefix. Same way, OH CH2 group, this formation having any compound, we can say that is L, okay. The actual reason for DL, I told dextrorotatory and levorotatory. The same way we can write ribose, D-glucose, all the compound, okay. Next, classification of carbohydrate. So, already I told how you classify the compound based on their product formed in the hydrolysis, okay. So, if you hydrolyze the carbon compound, carbohydrate, it will give different product. Based on the product, we can classify mono, oligo, and then polysaccharides, okay. Now, in detail, we are going to learn about monosaccharides, okay. So, monosaccharides means what? Most abundant or the maximum amount of glucose, that monosaccharides only present in the living organism, okay. Then what is the meaning of that mono? Mono means one, we know that, okay. So if you hydrolysis this monosaccharide, it will not give any further new product, okay. So further you cannot hydrolysis further. That compounds are called monosaccharides, okay. Further, you cannot again divide into smaller compounds on hydrolysis. We can say they are monosaccharides, okay. Many examples for monosaccharide, glucose, glucose, fructose, ribose, ethrose, like many monosaccharides, we may know that, okay. So, in that, we have the further classification based on the functional group or and number of carbon, we have further classification. So we know that what is monosaccharide. Further we cannot hydrolysis into smaller group. Okay, some example we have seen. Okay, one more thing, up to 20 naturally occurring monosaccharides we have. Okay, next to that, this monosaccharide further divided into two category based on the functional group and number of carbon. Okay, aldehyde functional group present means we can say aldose. Ketone functional group present means we can say ketose. Okay, so aldose, ketose, one carbohydrate that is monosaccharide. That monosaccharide having aldehyde functional group means we can say aldose. Ketone functional group present means ketose. Okay, next, number of carbon we have to see. Three carbon have in the aldose, we can say aldo. So three carbon means tri. Aldo triose. Suppose four carbon means aldo tetrose. Five carbon means aldo pentose. Okay, ketone carbon means how will you name three carbon with the ketone functional group? Keto triose, keto detrose. So like we can classify many compound based on their functional group and its number of carbon present in the monosaccharides. Okay, right. Next, the familiar monosaccharide we are going to see, that is nothing but glucose. So what is the molecular formula for glucose? C6H12O6. This is simplest sugar. Okay, very important and also very essential sugar. We know that glucose, okay, which is present in honey, then some sweet fruits like mangoes and also grapes. Okay, but in old book they are given, that is grain alcohol, we can obtain from the grains also. But in the new book they are given, we have 100 milligram of glucose in blood. If you take 100 milligram of blood, we can find some amount of glucose. So this also called blood sugar. Glucose also called blood sugar because which is present 100 mg/dL in the blood. So the glucose also called blood sugar, right? Some glucose compound in combined nature present in starch, cellulose, like other saccharide compounds also. Now the preparation of glucose. First preparation from the cane sugar. So cane sugar is nothing but sucrose. What is the molecular formula for sucrose? C12H22O11. On hydrolysis, means the reaction with water in the presence of H2SO4 acid. So what will happen? It will give one glucose and one fructose. The same way you can prepare from the starch, okay, polysaccharide like starch in the presence of HCl with temperature and pressure, under the temperature and pressure condition, 2 to 3 atmosphere. Here we can take the general molecular formula for starch, that is N times. If you take on hydrolysis, it will give N time of C6H12O6 all glucose. What are the condition? Hydrochloric acid, 2 to 3 atmosphere pressure and also 299 Kelvin temperature. We can prepare glucose. Remaining we will see in the next video.